In today's class, I would like to discuss about principles that guide practice. Okay, now we are going to learn the principles. Okay, if you learn the principles, then while practicing or while developing a software, okay, so you will get some easiest solutions while working with some software. Then learning a methods. Okay, so for that case, here we are going to learn the principles of a practice. So coming to the first principle, what is the principle one? Divide and conquer. What is the principle one? While working with your project, okay, first of all, you should apply divide and conquer, which means this statement means, first of all, you should divide your total work into a number of subparts. Okay, find out the solution for each and every small part. Okay, solution one for problem one, solution two, solution three, solution four, like that. At the end, okay, you should go for combining all the solutions to get final output. Okay, what you need to do here, you should perform, divide your problem into a sub problems. Try to find out the solution for each and every sub problem. Later, you should combine all the solutions of sub problems. Okay, to get final output of the total problem. So here, dividing of sub problems is called, the problem into sub problems is called a divide. The conquer means the combining of all the solutions, combining of all the sub problem solutions. Okay, to get to get the final outcome of that particular related project is called a conquer. So while working with your project, first you should do divide and conquer, apply divide and conquer method to your particular project. Clear? It is stated more technical manner. Analysis and design should always emphasize separation of concerns. So here we need to analyze each and every subproblem. Design accordingly. Try to get the solution for each and every subproblem. At the end, you should combine or you should conquer your results to get a final outcome or to reach your business goal. Clear? This is about principle one. Coming to the second one, principle two. Even principle one also, if you will take a real-time examples, if you will take a real-time example, if you want to conduct a, okay, if you want to conduct one quiz in your college, there is some, a function is going on, technical fest is going on in your college, then if you want to conduct some technical activities related to that particular fest, so what you are going to do? Okay, you should assign each and every activity to your friends. If you are a leader, assume, so how you are going to assign? Okay, call some 421, okay, better to prepare some technical quiz, okay, technical quiz questions from so-and-so unit. And you will ask for some 4A0 is there. So ask the A0, okay, collect questions from some other subject. Like that, you will assign each and everyone some task, okay, to fulfill the technical quiz related work. At the final, okay, gathering the all the questions from your friends, okay, by calling individual ones, and you will collect the questions from all, and you are going to conduct a technical quiz to whoever the participants, isn't it? So this is dividing of task, okay. So this is one kind of sharing of work, and by, if you will do like this, it will give solutions easily. May give okay, individual may collect, one person may collect some questions from one subject, means it's okay, all will do. Okay, like that, if you will assign for 10 members, okay, from 10 subjects, 10 members are collecting the questions from 10 subject. At the end of the day, okay, we are going to take all the questions from all the 10 friends, and the next day we are going to start a quiz. Okay, this is also one of the real-time example for a divide and conquer, isn't it? So this is first one. Coming to the second one, understand the use of abstraction. What it is? So understand the use of abstraction. Actually, this abstraction is one kind of activity. Activity in the sense, abstraction is it hides something. It hides something, okay, related to a particular task. Which means, if somewhere some complex things are came into picture, okay, how to overcome that complex functions, and how to provide a simple solutions for that particular complex functions. Such kinds of things will be get in this, you should perform in this abstraction, I mean, perform in the project. Okay, at its core, an abstraction is simplification of some complex element of a system, used to communicate meaning in a single phrase. Okay, which means, it will give some solutions directly. Okay, it will show some solutions to the users. How it will get the solutions? It will hide some things. Which means, if your friend is asked, by tomorrow, I want. something which means okay, suppose by tomorrow morning I need some cake, okay, for celebrating some inauguration or some R&D cell inauguration or something like that is going on even in our college. Assume that tomorrow morning one kind of function, one small activity is going on in your college campus. At the same time, okay, he told to you, please bring a cake for me, like that he told to you. So what you are going to do at that time? Okay, so you will prepare one cake, and by tomorrow morning you will give that cake to your friend, whoever is there. So at that time, pain you have taken to prepare that cake, nobody wants that one, isn't it? So for that cake, you are okay roaming around the city, or otherwise yourself you prepared, otherwise you asked to your mother to make some cake, like that. So whatever the things happen to bring that particular cake, okay, you are automatically, you will hide something. And what are the result to that particular thing? Okay, that particular about that situation only everybody will talk. If it is available or not, nobody knows about that. If your friend told you, okay, at night 1 o'clock, what you should do? If he told, I want a cake, okay, by tomorrow 6 a.m., like that, he asked you to at night 1 a.m. At that time, How you will bring such kind of cake for him? If it is a riskiest one, isn't it? It's little bit riskiest one. So at the 1 o'clock no shops are open at that time. Okay, so for that you may take. It is some complex situation, complex thing raised in your life, one situation. So how to handle that situation? Okay, so it's also like that. Here also, while doing some works, if some complex situations rise up or will occur while working with that, how to handle those complex situations? Okay, in a smooth manner, how you are going to handle those things? If any unnecessary things are there, better to hide those. Only you should concentrate on necessary things itself. Isn't it? So this is the second one. Coming to third one, strive for consistency, which means whatever you are preparing towards that project, everything should be fulfilled with completeness. Okay, don't leave even small point related to that particular function. Okay, don't leave single thing related to fulfill that particular function. Okay, without that also, okay, it will be executed, no problem. Okay, no need to write that line of code, or no need to do this one. Without this one also, it will be worked properly. Okay, for example, if you are using in C language, if you are using some power formula into your program, assume that. Okay, whenever you want to use that power function into your program, you must write the header file at the top of your program. Okay, each and everything you should include some header files, some mathematical. If you want to use mathematical functions into your program, you must write math.h in header file, isn't it? So if you neglect that one, if you neglect to write math.h, if you won't write, that will be executed for some systems. It won't give any kind of problems. Without writing math.h in header files also, some systems allow to execute your program and it will give the exact result, whatever you are expecting from your program. Okay, this is correct. Okay, but for some systems, some technologies, some softwares won't accept. It will be asked for, okay, something is missed. I don't understand what is the POW, whichever you have used in your coding. Like that, it will instruct you. Something you have missed. Like that, it will instruct you. Isn't it? So, such kind of problems may occur if you take light in some situations. Okay, it is work out for my system. Okay, after hand over this project to customer also, for his also it will be worked. How it will be worked? You don't know which kind of software he is using. Okay, in which kind of environment he is going to use this kind of project, you don't know. So in such a cases, okay, you won't neglect such kind of small things. You should be put everything 100% perfect. Whatever you are doing in your work, should try to implement. Okay, don't deviate even single point. Don't deviate even single point. Try to give over 100% effort and try to implement each and every small point. That is consistency. Okay, whether it will be consistent one or not, if single thing is deviated, it's not fulfilled properly, isn't it? If it is worked without writing some header files into, without including header files into your program, it will be worked for your system. Maybe your system is a high-end system. Okay, but the customer may not be used that high-end systems. So for him it will give some errors. So what it so how he will respond at that time? Clear? So everything, whatever you are doing, you should fight for completing. Okay, and some easiest way of working. So a familiar context makes a software easier to use. So whatever the software you have prepared, that is very easier to use by a customer. So this is the third one. Coming to the fourth one, focus on the transfer of information. Focus on the transfer of information, which means while doing, okay, while working with your project, pay special attention on each and every part. Okay, it may be analysis part or design part or construction part or testing part. Each and every, some interfaces you will have. So if your thingy is transferring from one page to another page, okay, that will be reached to properly or not. Suppose if I have filled the details of page one, if you are going to fill up an application, suppose if you're going to fill up the application for railway reservation or something, so there are many interfaces or many pages into to complete that process. So first process is this one, second process is this one, third process is this one, like, okay, while moving from one page to another page, it should carry the information properly. Otherwise, okay, you won't get, proper results. If you'll take the another example, okay. Another example in the sense, if you want to book a ticket, movie ticket. So how you are going to book a movie ticket? Okay, first, what is the first page? First page is selection of either movie or theater. So after choosing that one, what is the second page? Okay, second page is automatically how many number of seats you want. Okay, if you will select 3. So after that, it should calculate the amount for, it should calculate the amount for 3 tickets according to your selection of seats. If you select a first class or second class or third class or some more than the first class, some gold seats or some other seats also available in theaters, right? According to that, it should calculate the amounts and displays to you. Okay, if you will book a tickets for first class 3 seats, assume first class means each and every ticket has 300 rupees. So at the end of that page, if you will move to the next page, what it will show? 300 means 300 plus, suppose any internet charges means some 50 rupees or 40 rupees, some taxes or everything, it's maybe 350. Okay, like that it will show. But instead of showing 350, okay, it will show only 150. Okay, what should you do? Is it a correct information, proper information? Okay, while transferring from one page to another page, while booking your ticket, actually, according to your knowledge, so it is a 350, but it will show only 150. So you think that, okay, for 3 members, 150, okay, he may give only offer, I think so. Like that, 50% is offer he has given. Like that, if you will book that ticket, so automatically it will give only one ticket. So it's one kind of wrong leading, isn't it? Such things may be happened if you are not developed a proper, okay, interfaces. If the information is moving from one page to another page, one place to another place. So that the communication between those two interfaces should be perfect, 100%. Then only the final outcome will be good. Otherwise, okay, it is not worth the full one. Okay, if one time you will face this kind of situations, you never go to book a ticket through this online websites, isn't it? Online apps. So while working with this kind of projects, should be careful. Okay, in between the interfaces, right? This is another one. And even some money transactions also, even if you will go for a bank, if you will deposit 5,000 rupees into bank, but while getting a mobile information, it will only show you have deposited only 2,000 rupees just now. Like that, if you will get the information message related to your amount deposition, is it correct information? No. Which means, while transferring to your mobile that information, something is wrong in between, isn't it? Or otherwise, if you deposit only 5,000 into your account, okay, it will show you have deposited 10,000 rupees into your account. Like that, it will show you means, is this is also a one kind of fair information? No. But while watching that one, we'll be little bit feel happy for 1 minute. But after that, what we thought, that is not our money. We are not deposited 10,000. Only we have deposited 5,000. Okay, what is this information? How we get that information wrongly? Like that, we are going to inquire that bank people or somebody. Isn't it? Or otherwise, we are going to check our account details immediately. Right? So this is also one kind of transferring the information. Transferring the information. If we are going to see the fifth one, the fifth one is build software that exhibits effective modularity. So already about this modularity, in the sense we have discussed about that. What it is that? In first point itself, which means divide a big problem into sub-problems and find out the solution for each and every sub-problem. Finally, you should combine all the solutions to get a final outcome. Is that right? So that is called a one kind of problem division. So whatever the software you are going to design, that software should have should exhibit the effective modularity. Okay, separation of concern establishes a philosophy of software. Modularity provides a mechanism for realizing the philosophy, which means we should separate. Here already we have given some principle one. So principle one means it is almost related to a first problem, divide and conquer. Divide and conquer means divide and conquer should be applied to a individual module. Okay, so the total work is divided into either sub problems or individual modules. Okay, so that module will be divided into, again, in each and every module you may apply divide and conquer nature, right? Okay, suppose if you will assign some works to your friends, okay, related to conduct a function, your friends may take the help of some other friends to fulfill that work, isn't it? If you will assign one work to 5 members of your friends, that 5 members is going and assigning or take the help of again the 15 members. Each member take 3 members. So like that, in a manner you are going to work, dividing level wise. So at your point, you are divided only five groups. But your friend's point of view, that may be again they are going to divide into three groups. So like that, in such a manner, this work is going to, okay, divide and get the solutions. Clear? This is called modularity. And for coming to the sixth one, look for a pattern, which means, so whatever the project you are developing, for that you should get ready one pattern. Okay, like one design. So related to that problem, first of all, you will take some outline of that particular problem. How, if this is the problem, so for this problem, how we are going to give the solutions of that particular problem. That solutions are available in outside or not, isn't it? If one kind of problem you will get, so what is the solution, that one? If the solution is, if you are ready one solution, that may be used by many people who have faced the same problem while developing that kind of projects. In such a manner, you should give the designs. Clear? Which means, if you have provide so one solution to a problem, okay, that solution may be a universal solution for many problems. Whatever the solution you have find, that is a universal solution for many, many problems. So in such a way, you should develop the solutions or designs to your project. Then that is called a one kind of template or one kind of pattern. Clear? Like one kind of innovation. Suppose if you developed a wedding card, which is very nice. Okay, till now it's not that kind of wedding card not available in market. In such a way, if you prepared one wedding card, so by seeing your wedding card, many people are trying to implement that designs in everywhere, isn't it? Okay. So like that, which means your design, whatever you have implemented, okay, that is one kind of trend, one kind of okay, good one. By seeing that wedding card, all are going to use such kind of that related similar designs into their wedding cards. So in such a way, you should work on your project. Everything is unique. Whatever the things you are going to, use into your project. What are the solutions you are going to provide for your project? Those should be a unique ones. Then only if whenever you will implement a unique one, then many people who are facing a same problem would follow your solution itself. Like that, you should design some patterns. And coming to the second one, seventh one, sorry, what it is, when possible, represent the problem and its solutions from a number of different perspectives. What we have to do here? If possible, represent the problem and its solutions from a number of different perspectives. Whatever the solution you find, that is not suitable for, that is suitable for many, we have discussed in sixth point, many problems. It may solve many problems, not only one problem, it may solve many problems. Like that, you should develop, solution to a one problem. If you found one solution to a one problem, It may solve many problems, not only related problems and non-related problems also by using your formula or by using your solution. It is going to solve everything. Okay, so like that, you should try to prepare. Okay, and otherwise, in real time, generally paste is used to clean our mouth, isn't it? Okay, that is always used, we are going purchasing and use it for to wash our mouth itself, clear? But somebody used that paste to clean ornaments. Do you know this? Okay, somebody used this paste, toothpaste to clean the ornaments. That is second purpose. And coming to the third purpose, that same paste is used by some people, okay, where the skin, some burnings is happening in your skin, to heal those burns, they are applying the toothpaste on that particular burning places to heal that things. So that is the third use of a paste. So like that, actually we have developed that paste is only one, toothpaste is for only one purpose, to clean our mouth. That is our main motive. Okay, but that toothpaste is used for many other purposes too. Many other purposes too. So ornaments cleaning, okay, it is too different for teeth cleaning, isn't it? But for such cases also, many people are used this paste. And to heal if something is burned on our hands or somewhere, for to heal those things also, you are going to apply that same toothpaste. So like that, you are going to, if you build one solution for one problem, which means, what is the solution here? Our problem is cleaning of teeth. For that, they are finding one solution, toothpaste. That paste is used to provide a solution for cleaning of teeth. That is, finally, it's clear. By seeing one paste, many people are developed, many kinds of people, by adding new items into that paste. That is also one kind of patterns. Here the pattern is, if you are the first person to find a paste or to develop a paste to mouth, toothpaste, so you are the first person. Okay, so that is a one kind of pattern, one kind of template. By seeing your template, many people are getting some kind of same related toothpaste. But they'll change a little bit, some packs, some inside the items. Okay, somebody is telling some neem or salt or something. Okay, so different things, different kinds of paste are available after, seeing one's product, isn't it? So that is a sixth point. Coming to seventh point, if you find one solution, that solution may be help to solve some other problems which may relate to a same thing or some other thing. Like that, you should provide, or if you design your solutions towards your project. That is the seventh one. Coming to the eighth one, remember that someone will maintain the software. So what you should remember that? You are not going to use that software. You are just a developer. Okay. Don't try to, implement, or don't try to provide the solutions. Okay. That is easy to you or easy to a technical persons. Okay. Whatever the solution you are providing to that problem, that is used by somebody. Okay, he may be an educated person or non-educated person. or he may be technical or non-technical. So there are different kind of people in I mean real world. So your product is going to serve those kind of people in such a cases, your product should help to serve those. Your product is understand by those people. Okay, the stakeholder may be a educated one or not. Suppose if I am the client for one project, okay, if I am not the suppose if I'm like what only I have 7th standard lady only. Suppose I have passed, that's it, 7th standards only. But then also I asked you to prepare some one kind of app to increase my business. I have my own some other business like that. So whatever you have developed, that is understand by me. Okay, that is not for you. You are not coming to my home daily and you are not going to teach that particular thing, whatever you have developed. So while seeing that app itself, I should understand everything. It is related to me. Okay, it is designed for me. Even though I am a 7th standard passed woman, isn't it? So like that, in such a manner, okay, you should develop your software. Which means sometimes while executing some programs, okay, while taking the input, if you will give the printf statement, enter the values for A and B, then if you will provide a scanf for A and B, then it will show in your output screen. Okay, first line is enter the values for A and B, then the cursor is blinking. There you will enter A value is 5, B value is 6, and later you will get the output. Okay, that is. So if in output screen, if you will observe that enter the values for A and B, if you will see that, okay, anybody can understand, okay, now we need to give some values to A and B. Okay, then they are ready to type the values without putting that printf statement directly. If you have taken scanf statement in your program, what it happens? Okay, in output screen, in black screen, just one white cursor will be blinking. It doesn't give any kind of instructions to us. If you are the same person using that, I mean, if you are the same person using that one, you know what you are entered in your program, and okay, here I have to give some, okay, this is the scanf place. I should enter the A value, B value, and automatically it will give the output like that. You have some idea. So what is the program you have written and what is the output you will get? But if there is a new person, he always work with your output screen. He doesn't know your input screen. He always work with your output screen. What he should understand there? Nothing. Okay, if the cursor is blinking, means what he should do at that time? So there is no clear instructions. So at that time, what you have to do while writing that program? Otherwise, you write, first of all, enter A value. So the cursor is blinking beside. Then you will enter the A value. After pressing enter, I mean, after the next line, enter B value. So you will enter the B value also. Okay, the result is, okay, so on, so on. Like that, it will give that clear instructions on output screen. Everybody can understood without seeing the what input program, whatever you have given. No need to see the total program. Just by watching output itself, okay, what we should do here? Okay, what is the next? What is next? Like that. Okay, this is the result for this program. What are the values I have entered in the above on the screen? Like this, it will be worked. So there is that such kind of ideas will get if he is a new person to that something program. So like that, you should implement. Okay, don't implement for your purpose. Right? These are the 8 principles related to a practice.